Hello guys, welcome back to episode 7 of Cmake shared libraries. So what are shared libraries? Shared libraries are the dynamic link libraries in Windows. Link libraries are the libraries which can be linked with a program at compile time or at runtime. So what is the benefit of a DLL or a shared library? So shared library is something like that which can be loaded at runtime, and it reduces this amount of space because there is some set amount of code which is stored in a different file, not on executable. An executable consumes that code at runtime, so the executable itself is not that much big in size and not containing the whole definition and declaration of the code. Some amount of code is stored in a separate file which is loaded at runtime, and it helps in multiple applications can use that same DLL, and this reduces the usage of memory as well, and it's really helpful. So let's jump into the Cmake list and see how shared libraries are created using Cmake.
Alright guys, let's see how Cmake will generate shared library for us. To generate a shared library, first of all, I have created a file name sharedlibrary.h. As you can see here, it is sharedlibrary.h, which will contain the method declaration of a void type void say hello. Then I have created file name sharedlibrary.cpp, which includes a header file sharedlibrary.h, which contains a declaration of say hello. As you can see, say hello of a void type, it contains a declaration of say hello. In this shared library.cpp, I have defined say hello with a simple cout statement, which you can see hello from shared library. Then we will use shared keyword with add library method, which we have already used in our previous video of static library. This keyword will tell Cmake to generate shared library for us using sharedlibrary.cpp file. Now we will start building up our solution, and it will generate sharedlibrary.dll for us. So first of all, I will right click on the solution, then I will click on build solution, so it will start building up and everything is built up. So now we need to navigate that where the sharedlibrary.dll is present. So I will click on this solution and click on this open folder in file explorer. Then this is a debug project, then navigate to the debug folder, and here it is, sharedlibrary.dll is generated successfully. Then I have created a main.cpp, which contains the executable code which will going to use that shared library header. If you can see here, hashtag include sharedlibrary.h. In our main.cpp, I will call the function which is defined in sharedlibrary.cpp and declared in sharedlibrary.h, say hello, and let's see it will run with that DLL or not. One thing I need to mention here, that Cmake generate two types of project. One is sharedlib and one is shared library under the one solution. So Cmake is generating this project because we have added two, we are using two methods. One is add library and one is add executable. So add library is creating one project which is named as shared library with generate.dll file, and another one is add executable, which is shared lib. If you see the name here and shared library and shared lib, so add executable is generating another project which is responsible for generating an executable file. So now let's build again this sharedlib project, which is executable project, and see that the executable successfully run or not using that DLL. Okay, when I build this one, okay, so I can see that the link error cannot open file sharedlibrary.lib. So it needs .lib file which contains the links to the DLL file, which tell linker that where it should see for DLL file. So we need to set a flag for the generation of .lib file. Okay, so we need to set this flag in a cmake list.txt. Here you can see set cmake windows export all symbols on. Okay, so this flag is specific to the windows because Windows contains links to the DLL in .lib and the binary code in .dll file. Okay, for the Linux, SO contains .so file contains everything. So this flag is just specific for the Windows. After you set this flag to on, you will go on the shared library project, and when you click build again, you will see one succeeded, and when you go in that debug folder, you will see shared library.lib is there. Try to run that executable so it will run successfully. Okay, so you need to add one more thing, which is pragma comment lib shared library.lib. Okay, so this pragma comment will look in shared library.lib folder for the DLL links. When you run this project now, you will see it will successfully run hello from shared library. So this is how Cmake generates shared library in Windows, and this is the same process for the Linux as well, but the extension in Windows will be .dll and for the Linux the extension will be .so. So
I hope you guys learned how to create shared libraries using Cmake. Thank you guys, keep watching, keep supporting, and please subscribe my channel.